Yo, what's good, guys? This is Chris from WearTesters.com. Welcome back to the official WearTesters.com YouTube channel, the only sneaker channel here on YouTube where you come for the review and stay for the conversation. Today, we're talking about these bad boys right here. At least I hope they're bad boys in the future. And this is the Mamba Focus. So this is Kobe Bryant's latest basketball sneaker from Nike, and it's another one of their budget models. Another one of their lower priced options, for those of you guys that don't like the term budget. These guys retail for $100, which is not too bad. However, I don't think, like, especially after trying them on, I don't think that they're necessarily going to please everybody. Normally I start off with the traction, but today we're gonna switch it up a little bit. Today we are talking about the fit first, and the fit is very weird. Shout out to my friend Vince, Shades and Soles on YouTube. He actually bought these, and he bought his normal, like, true size, and he gave me a call, or he actually didn't give me a call. I've rarely talked to people over the phone, but he texted me and he was just like, I bought these and they fit a little bit long. Did you want my pair? And I was kind of like, that's weird. Like, Kobe's normally don't fit long. You know what I mean? And I'm a half a size bigger than him typically. So he brought them over. I tried them on, and sure enough, man, they fit a little bit long. So I was like, all right, cool. So I grabbed them from him. Shout out to you. I really appreciate it. However, they are very, very narrow on top of being long. So they reminded me a little bit of these things right here. This is the Nike LeBron Witness 3. I do not like playing in these. Like, they feel very similar to these, so I'm wondering if they're built on the same last. They're both kind of that budget or lower priced offering from Nike Basketball and each of their respective signature lines, so it's very possible. All I know is that they fit very similar, and these guys are a titch too long and really, really tight on my feet, and I like a snug fit, but damn, these are way too tight. So yeah, I don't like playing in these. The longer that I play in them, the more, like, my feet feel like they're gonna hulk out of them, and I don't like that feeling. I like the feeling of, like, a nice one-to-one, and this is like a straight jacket. It's a little too much. So for anybody wanting to grab these, hopefully they're available in a store near you. That way you can actually try them on first, because again, they fit a little bit long, but they're very, very narrow. Now, moving on to the traction. We actually have snake scales right here. We have seen this on past Kobe signature models before. This pattern is slightly different though. What I love about them is that this guy right here uses gum rubber, at least for, you know, half of it. And on top of that, the rubber itself feels very thick and firm. So I think that a lot of people that are, you know, really wanting outdoor shoes, for whatever reason, the lower price models usually have that. I don't know why. You would think that they'd make the higher price models more durable, I guess, but I think that those are just, you know, designed specifically for indoor use, so they don't ever think about outdoor athletes. Whereas these guys right here are made for pretty much everybody. So again, each of these little, you know, nubs right here or whatever, little scales are really thick, they're very firm, all that stuff. So I think that this is going to last pretty decently outside. However, for being a shoe that is outdoor friendly, the cushion, much like the rest of, you know, the lower price models from the Kyrie Flytrap 2, even the first one, and the Witness, although those have full length air, so it's a little bit better, but the cushion in these guys is lacking, in my opinion, at least the way that it's implemented. So we have a traditional Phylon midsole here, no drop-in setup this time around. So I know a lot of people are a little bit bummed about that, because they have had previous drop-in midsole setups before, like the Mamba Mentality and shoes like that, like the Rage. This guy, it's just, you know, a traditional build. So you have a midsole with the upper built on top of that, not a shell with a drop-in within. And then the forefoot actually has, you know, Zoom Air. They show you that right there. It not only says Zoom, but it also showcases exactly where it's at. So that's not a large Zoom unit, in my opinion. It might be fairly thick. It might be about 8 millimeters thick, which is a good size, but being that little tiny rectangle, it's just, you know, very minimal coverage. And then on top of that, it's encased within the Phylon, which is then encased within this rubber. So the forefoot is a cup sole, basically. It's wrapping all the way around. There's no way for the Phylon to expand or move. So when you try them on, the forefoot feels extremely firm. Like, it basically feels like you're on the floor, which is great for people that want court feel. Not so great for people playing outdoors with a nice durable outsole like this that want a little bit of extra protection for their body when they're on the blacktop. Now the upper on these guys, I was actually surprised with. It's probably my favorite part of the shoe. These guys right here feature a fabric build, which is just pretty interesting. It's not like anything mind-blowing, but for $100, it's pretty nice. It's a nice little textile. It's gonna move around with your foot and all that kind of good stuff. There is something lining behind it, so I think there's some nylon glued back there. And then you can see the fuse that are welded onto the high wear areas. The eyelet specifically, this area really needs that extra reinforcement just so that you don't rip through the textile. And then obviously the toe drag area. I do think that this area right here, it just looks really bad. It looks unfinished. I don't know why they separated the fused tape like that, but for whatever reason they did. But the overall look really reminds me of the Kobe 6. These guys have a screen mesh with polyurethane scales on top, so a little bit more premium, if you will, even though it's not like exactly premium. But then this guy kind of gives you that same similar look without the shine and all that stuff. It does not have additional layers or anything, but it does have that same visual, which is a pretty cool callback to one of the best, in my opinion at least, the best Kobe model of all time. And then we have a standard TPU heel counter right there in the back. I really like the way that this looks. It just has a premium look to it. I dig the extra scales and all that stuff. It's something that they could definitely cheap out on. They could just put on some little plastic wing or something like that. They don't even have to do anything. They could put in, you know, an internal one that has no, you know, look to it whatsoever, no design or aesthetic. But instead, they give you something a little bit extra. It's got the Kobe Shizuoka logo on there, and again, the scales. So I think that it's just a nice little added feature, especially for $100. It gives you the signature feel without it being completely a signature shoe. Now, one drawback to the shoe, I don't know if it's going to be an actual problem, it's just something that I'm hoping isn't, is the swoosh placement. It's an interesting look for one, but the way that it's placed, it kind of pops up right here and your foot actually does rest right in there. So I think that upon certain movements, that could actually like pinch or push or stab, whatever you want to call it, right into your foot right there upon certain moves. So hopefully that's not a problem, but that's just kind of like a holy crap, I hope that's not an issue type of little design piece right there. And then I love that they put an outrigger on there, even though it's a small one. I just like that it's there. It widens the base just enough to give you some extra stability while you're hooping. So that pretty much takes care of it for these guys right here. Again, this is the Mamba Focus. This is a budget or, you know, lower price signature sneaker. It's $100. They're available now in two colorways, one of which is this guy right here, as well as just a simple black and white. Outdoor friendly, lacks a lot of cushion. I'll see how they play once my knee is, or not my knee, my calf. What the hell is wrong with my knee now? Nothing? Nothing? I'm just making up stuff. But once my calf is healed, I will give these, along with all the other stuff that I'm currently backed up with, a spin on court, and hopefully they play nicely, because on foot they just are not very impressive right now. Sound off below and let us know what you guys think about these down below in the comment section. We appreciate you guys for watching. We appreciate you guys for giving us a thumbs up if you like the video. We appreciate you guys for subscribing. So until next time, guys, have a good one. Yo, dude, I forgot to do it.
What did you do?
You gotta look at the camera now. You gotta say it with me.
Oh.
Mamba face.
I know that Kobe's and all of these shoes from Nike, they're supposed to be primarily basketball first, but I gotta say...
Wait, what do you mean primarily? They are basketball
first. I have to say, the price and the looks, like, these are a clean summer shoe.
Oh, I think that these are gorgeous. I wasn't like thrilled with them when I first saw like leaked images and stuff like that. Actually, we were the first ones to post those, but then I got in trouble.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, but then when we saw like the official, like, they're not official, but the other like leaked images of official images, they were in these, the black ones. There's a red one coming out, because this is going to be like, they're going to come out in like a bunch of different colors. And I just thought that they were clean, this one being the best looking one so far.
Mm-hmm.
And like, first off, you can't go wrong with this color scheme, this wear testers.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? The black, white, and gum. I just think that that's great. I like that it's got two looks.
Yes.
You know, so like if you're wearing them and you're running, you got kind of two shoes on, even
right,
though you don't. And I think that's cool, again, for $100, because that's something that's popular right now. And that's what I do like about all of these affordable options, from the Flytrap to the Witness to this guy, is that they're at least giving you signature stuff, much like what we had as kids, the Jordan Team stuff. The funny thing, though, is that these are more accepted than Jordan Team shoes.
Different age.
I guess, but still, like, I just think it's funny that, like, a Team Kobe or a Team LeBron or a Team Kyrie, everybody's like, sweet.
Right.
Then you put out a Team Jordan, they've been doing it from the jump, and then everybody's like, boo. I'm kind of like, come on, man. Like, so it's a little weird, but I agree. These are gorgeous. I think the price is right. The tech specs, you can feel it, though. You know what I mean? Like, sometimes they, like, nail it with, like, a $100 shoe, and you're like, yo, these are, like, hella comfortable.
Right.
All this stuff, and then other times... they give you what basically, I guess, they expect you to get, which is not much. That's all you got? Okay. Yeah, that was another. Remember, that was another fake one. What's with you and the fake laughs? Fire Marshal Jody. So that pretty much takes care of it.